Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel Vocavita English. Today's video is all about active listening. Do you know what is the difference between listening and active listening? Not all listening is the same. Listening without reacting, allowing someone to speak without interrupting, is passive listening. Active listening, on the other hand, includes responses that demonstrate that you understand what the other person is trying to tell you about his or her experience. Active listening is a skill that can be acquired and developed with practice. Active listening involves listening with all senses. So warm up your senses. Here I brought a listening text for you that's going to make understanding English a piece of cake for you. But before we start, keep your notepad and pen ready with you and remember three things. Firstly, pay attention and listen carefully to everything. Secondly, drill down the details. That means note down the important points while you are listening to the text. Third, retain and reproduce answers at the end of the text. At the end of the text, when the questions will be asked, you should be ready with the information, whatever you have heard, you have noted down, either it's in your mind or it is on the notepad. Yes, you are able to recall and generate the answers. Firstly, I'll be reading the questions based on the passage. The passage will be read at normal reading speed. You may take notes during the reading. After the reading, you can try to answer some of the questions. I shall read the passage second time and you may take further notes and answers. After this second reading, we will be revising what answers you have written and you can self-evaluate whether you have understood the listening text or you have to be a more attentive listener. So here are the questions sheet for you. Let me first read out the questions for you. First one, put a tick in the correct box according to whether the statement is true or false. First one, Carol Baines started studying when she was 12. Second, Carol Baines lived on a farm with her two sisters. Third, the closest school in the farm was 200 kilometers away. Fourth, they used the sitting room as a classroom. Fifth, they talked to the teacher and other students on the internet. Sixth, Carol Baines studied history, science and mathematics. B part. What do these words, dates and numbers refer to in the passage? First, 5. That means the number 5 in the passage that you're going to hear stands for what? Second, Alice Springs. This term refers to what? And third, 1948. C-section, fill in with one word from the passage. Just one word. First one, during the time she attended boarding school, Carol only went home during dash. Yes, you'll get this answer when you listen to the text. Second, at first, when Carol Baines went to the boarding school, she was very, So, the second dash will be filled again when you are going to listen very carefully to the text where this line was and what was the missing word. Yes? So now is the time to be an active listener. Listen to the text carefully. You are going to hear Carol Baines talking about her schooling in Australia. I didn't go to school until I was 12 years old. Before that, I studied at home with my brother and sister. We lived on a sheep station, a very big farm in Australia, and the closest school was 200 kilometers away. We studied a variety of subjects, and the school was called the School of the Air. Our classroom was the dining room, and we studied for 5 hours every day. We communicated with the teacher and other students by radio. My favorite subjects were history and science, and I did quite well in them. I didn't like maths, and I wasn't very good at it. In fact, my results in this subject were so unsatisfactory that my parents were very angry about it. We spent half an hour a day on the radio, read books, and wrote different kinds of stories, which were then sent to the school center in Alice Springs. The teacher, who visited us once a year, corrected them and sent them back to us by mail. These days, of course, the internet is widely used, but we didn't have computers at that time, so we couldn't communicate by email, and chatting was obviously unheard of. In 1948, my parents sent me to a boarding school in Brisbane. That was very different to what I was used to. There were a lot of other students, all with different personalities, and we lived at the school where we slept in the living quarters. I only went home during school holidays. Brisbane is a big, beautiful city by the sea. However, I was really sad and missed my family at first. I cried on my first day there, but after that, I enjoyed it very much. It is an experience that I will treasure for the rest of my life. So, how many answers have you got? Maybe all, maybe few, or some of you must have missed just one answer anywhere. Never mind. Listen to the text one more time. This time be more careful and attentive to answer all the questions. No, we don't have to leave any question unanswered. Yes, so here we go. The text a little more slowly so that you can understand it better. Yes, and improve your listening skill. Here's the text. Yes, keep an eye on the questions and see what all answers you can write. Yes? You are going to hear Carol Baines talking about her schooling in Australia. I didn't go to school until I was 12 years old. Before that, I studied at home with my brother and sister. We lived on a sheep station, a very big farm in Australia, and the closest school was 200 kilometers away. We studied a variety of subjects, and the school was called the School of the Air. Our classroom was the dining room, and we studied for 5 hours every day. We communicated with the teacher and other students by radio. My favorite subjects were history and science, and I did quite well in them. I didn't like maths, and I wasn't very good at it. In fact, my results in this subject were so unsatisfactory that my parents were very angry about it. We spent half an hour a day on the radio, read books, and wrote different kinds of stories, which were then sent to the school center in Alice Springs. The teacher, who visited us once a year, corrected them and sent them back to us by mail. These days, of course, the internet is widely used, but we didn't have computers at that time, so we couldn't communicate by email, and chatting was obviously unheard of. In 1948, my parents sent me to a boarding school in Brisbane. That was very different to what I was used to. There were a lot of other students, all with different personalities, and we lived at the school where we slept in the living quarters. I only went home during school holidays. Brisbane is a big, beautiful city by the sea. However, I was really sad. I missed my family at first. I cried on my first day there. But after that, I enjoyed it very much. It is an experience that I will treasure for the rest of my life. Well done, active listeners. Now let's discuss the answers to the text. Yes. Now let's come to the question sheet. Check your answers. A part, put a tick in the correct box according to whether the statement is true or false. So let's do it together. First one, Carol Bean started studying when she was 12. Yes, that's true. So how many of you have written true? Carol Baines lived on a farm with her two sisters. Yes, true or false? It is false. She lived with her sister and brother. So second one is false. Third, the closest school in the farm was 200 kilometers away. That's true. Yes, it is true. Fourth one, they use the sitting room as a classroom. Sitting room, dining room, that is also true. They called to the teacher and other students on the internet. Fifth one, no, they call them on the radio, not on the internet. So, fifth one is false. Sixth, Carol Bain studied history, science and mathematics. Yes, history, science and mathematics, all these three subjects she had studied. Yes, so if you have written true and you have got till here all six correctly ticked, then very, very big congratulations to all of you for listening so attentively to the text. Let's come very fast to the B part. What do these words, dates and numbers refer to in the passage? First one, 5. Now 5 stands for what? You have heard the passage 2 times. So 5 refer to, check your answer. If you have written, we studied for 5 hours every day. Yes, that is, we studied for 5 hours every day. That is the first answer. Second, the school center is in Alice Springs. The second word is Alice Springs. And the reference is that the school center is in Alice Springs. Yes? 1948. In 1948, her parents sent her to a boarding school in Brisbane. Yes? So, congratulations if again you have written the correct answer to these questions. Still here, we are going good. All of you, very well done. Check the third part, that is the C part. Fill in with one word from the passage. Okay, so the first one is, during the time she attended boarding school, Carol only went home during, yes, can you recall, during holidays. It is written, heard, you must have heard school holidays. So but you have to write only one word. You cannot write school holidays and you cannot opt for school. Yes, obviously holidays is a much better reference. So you can use only one word and that one word for C part would be holidays. Second, at first, when Carol Baines went to a boarding school, she was very, remember? Yes, she was very sad. That word was loudly said during the listening text. Yes, so I hope all of you have got the answers correct. And in the comment box, you can let me know what is your score. Now you can go on explore more of the listening text and you'll be surprised how easy it has become to understand English. If you want me to bring more such informative videos, kindly subscribe, like and share my channel. Yes, do write a comment and tell me what was your score for today. Our next video would be on improving English reading. Thank you for watching and I'll meet you every Wednesday and Saturday here on my YouTube channel. Till then, happy learning!